Tot slot iets vrolijkers. Dancing Queen wordt waarschijnlijk zoiets als danskoningin of dansprinses. Waterloo gewoon, Waterloo. En the day before you came, de dag voordat je kwam of zo. Toch schijnt het een leuke musical te worden. Ik heb het over Mamma Mia. Begin september gaat hij in Nederland in première. De drijvende kracht achter dit project is Bjorn Ulveus, inderdaad de Bjorn van ABBA. Hij bemoeide zich hoogstpersoonlijk met het uitkiezen van de hoofdrolspelers. En Alje Kamphuis, die zocht hem op in Stockholm.
What is the winner takes it all in Dutch?
De winner krijgt de prijs, something like that. Did you understand that?
Yeah, de winnaar krijgt de prijs.
Yeah, exactly. De winnaar krijgt de prijs. The winner takes it all.
I can hear that sound miles away. I can hear, you know, someone playing that the other side of the street. I just know the sound. That's ABBA.
De musical Mamma Mia, gebaseerd op 22 hits van ABBA, gaat 4 jaar geleden in Londen in première en is nog steeds iedere avond uitverkocht. De productie staat inmiddels ook op Broadway. Er is een Duitse en Japanse versie. En vanaf september is de productie ook in Nederland te zien.
It was such an experiment, you know. And I was ready at any point to call it off and say that no, it doesn't work. It's no use. Let's not do it. I was scared.
Why?
As well, because it could have been a bad impact on the songs, on the group, if it had not been, you know, really well done.
If you change your mind, take a chance, on the first in line. Watching the Eurovision Song Contest, or go out and see a movie?
Song Contest.
The Waterloo was wrong for Eurovision, yes.
Yeah?
Absolutely. We knew that. Going there, that this is not a Eurovision song.
Maar ABBA wint in 1974 met Waterloo het Eurovisie Songfestival. Bjorn heeft met Benny en manager Stig Andersson het lied geschreven. Maar hij mag de prijs niet in ontvangst nemen.
There was this stupid guy standing, you know, saying in front of me, saying that no, it's the writers. It's the writers of the songs are on stage now. But I am a writer. No, 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 no. So I wasn't allowed.
Yeah, but you wore that silly dress, that silly...
Yeah, that silly dress made it. But Benny got on stage with his silly dress. And so people, no. Then as when they called the group to then I was allowed. My God, that stupid guy. Can
you hear the drums, Fernando? In maart 1976 scoort ABBA met Fernando de eerste nummer 1 hit in Nederland. 3 maanden later gevolgd door de grootste ABBA-hit aller tijden, Dancing Queen. De enige nummer 1 hit in Amerika.
Frida is a mezzo soprano and Agnetha is a true soprano. So it's when Agnetha is in her, you know, where she should be, and Frida striving to get up there, and they sing in unison, gives it kind of a very attractive metallic sound, which is special for ABBA, I think. Pure coincidence.
Sure?
No, yes, of course. We met the girl socially, you know, always. I get the question, you know, wasn't that a gimmick? Didn't you dream that up, 2 married couples? And no, it was genuine, just happened.
Bij het maken van de musical Mamma Mia wordt alles gedaan om de ABBA-sound zo goed mogelijk te kopiëren. Uit Londen komt speciaal iemand naar Stockholm om met Bjorn de originele opnamebanden te beluisteren en om de zangpartijen noot voor noot uit te schrijven.
What you hear in Mamma Mia is exactly what we did on the records, and that had never been done before because we never wrote that down. We just did it, you know.
You never wrote?
No. Just how well, come? We wrote down the chords for the musicians, but that was all.
But how come?
Because neither Benny nor I can write music. I mean, orchestral notes.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding. It is the absolute truth. And that goes for, you know, a lot of other composers around the world, I'm sure. Give me a
man at the midnight. Stockholm or London?
Stockholm.
ABBA verkoopt wereldwijd 350 miljoen albums. In Zweden zelf is de groep minder geliefd. Het land beleeft op politiek gebied een uiterst linkse periode. En veel geld verdienen is vies. Bjorn verhuist mede om die reden enige tijd naar Engeland.
They thought that we were antichrist. I mean, the success, the fact that we sold so many records and all of that was something they didn't approve of. Instead of the critics, we read the faxes coming in from all over the world of, you know, chart positions and sales, which was an, you know, the evidence of that there was millions of people out there who liked what we did. So who would care about a critic in this country then?
In 1981 staat ABBA nog twee keer op nummer 1, maar een jaar later is het voorbij. Nadat eerder de twee huwelijken binnen de groep zijn gesneuveld, gaan de leden nu ook op muzikaal gebied hun eigen weg. Bjorn en Benny schrijven vervolgens de musical Chess met de wereldhit One Night in Bangkok.
We're not, you know, musical buffs as such, not at all. It was just the fascination of drama and music together. And we still are fascinated by that. And by, you know, being able to work with a lot of people on stage, live, and something magical happening, rather than, as we did, you know, traveling around the world, singing, lip-syncing to a tape. This is more interesting. The day
before you came. Chess or Mamma Mia?
Mamma Mia. Mamma Mia.
Het heeft iets komisch, ABBA in het Duits. Maar ook de Nederlandse versie krijgt Nederlandse teksten.
People are amazed in the beginning. They think, oh, this sounds strange. But after 5 minutes they're into the story and they forget. And the songs are, you know, carry the story forwards as well as the dialogue. So I'm a firm believer in translating everything.
It's silly, isn't it?
No, it's your language. How can that be silly?
Met de musical Mamma Mia staat ABBA 20 jaar na het opheffen van de groep weer volop in de belangstelling. De vier kregen een paar jaar geleden miljoenen aangeboden om nog een paar keer samen op te treden, maar niemand had er echt zin in. Onlangs maakten ze een uitzondering voor een vriendin die 50 werd.
I remember that was quite strange. Because automatically I was standing on one side and Benny on the other and the two girls in the middle. And while we were singing that song, I sort of looked across and there was Agneta, and it was the weirdest feeling. What is this? I recognize this.
Agneta or Frida?
Oh, Jesus. I'm glad I'm not married to either of them anymore. That is one impossible question. I'll be dead if I answer that.